While presenting a statement to Parliament of unanswered questions about abductions and disappearances of NUP supporters, the leader of opposition, Mathew Simpuga, also read out the list of names of those that were arrested.
Moses Simbabazi, Dennis Zimola, Shafiki Wangolo, Martin Rukwago, Peter Kiria, John Damulira, Michael Semudu, Mohamed Kanata, John Bosco Chibalama, who was last seen by the Prime Minister, Vincent Nalumoso, Yuda Sempija, Musisi Mboa, Mustafa Luemba, Hassan Mubiru, Isima Sesazi, Godfrey Kisembo, George Kasumba, and Joseph Baguma.
Mpuga added that keeping prisoners in jail without being taken to court for more than 24 hours is a gross human rights violation, while some are charged without proper evidence.
The arrest and detention of several Ugandans without trial represents one of the worst abuses of human rights. In the worst case scenario, where the state desired to hold on to detainees without probable cause, trumped up charges have been raised against them.
Mpuga also said the most disappointing thing is that everything is happening under Parliament's watch, but nothing is done. He also added those arrested are being tortured in prisons, but still nothing is done.
We shall not relent from exposing the systemic human rights abuses and to plead for the full intervention of Parliament in enlisting this problem and finding a durable solution.
The opposition now demands the government to provide information on those arrested in the November 2020 protests in Kampala and surrounding areas, to identify Muslims who have been arrested without execution, to release political prisoners, among others.
I listened to and read the statement by the Minister of Internal Affairs relating to the arrival and illegal arrest of the Honorable Kyagulanyi and hundreds of NUP supporters, thwarted NUP prayers and the dispersion of peaceful demonstrations in the Bali constituency. I submit that the minister's statement was superficial, shallow, tainted with the material falsehoods. I must state here that the minister's statement remains rejected, and I invite this Honorable House to consider it as such.
However, the Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Thomas Tayewa, disagreed with the allegations that Parliament has not done enough about human rights violations.
On 18th of August 2022, the House considered and debated the report of our own Human Rights Committee on the status of human rights and human rights violations in the country.
MPs want a petition about human rights violations to be taken to the National Human Rights Commission for full consideration. The State Minister for Internal Affairs, General David Mohozi, noted that most of the Leader of Opposition's demands had been already answered by government.
That government believes in the rule of law, and we believe in constitutionalism. The response could have been unsatisfactory, according to LOP, but that doesn't close the avenue for accountability, because we have courts in this country. We have the Uganda Human Rights Commission.
Meanwhile, the Leader of Opposition has accused the Prime Minister, Robinah Nabbanja, of knowing the whereabouts of NUP's Godfrey Chibalama.
The Prime Minister says he knows where Chibalama is. I asked the Honourable Prime Minister that I escort her to go and see Chibalama. And she is needed 30 days. And I want to put it to her that the blood of Chibalama, if he's dead, is on your hands.
Is it in order for my brother?
Thank you,
people still waiting that I have the blood of Chibarama. I have what? When in actual sense, I'm not a security person. Is it in order?
The speaker advised Minister Mohoz and the leader of opposition to meet and analyze the lists of those who are allegedly missing.
Because sometimes we don't know which kind of clarification you're seeking. You write to him where you feel the statement is not detailed enough. You ask for these details. And then you respond, we come here in 30 days and we handle it.
After this, the opposition left Parliament before the end of the Parliament session, something that angered the Deputy Speaker.
I don't at all enjoy presiding over a house which is one-sided. I don't.
Report compiled by Obed Lutali for the news.